course, Steph Curry with his dad, the emotions just pouring out. It might be his fourth, but it means so much. All the sacrifice, all the work. Boy, these Warriors are ready to celebrate. And that'll do it. It's over. The Golden State Warriors return to a familiar place. They're on top of the NBA world. The fourth title in 8 years. The Dubs dynasty is still very much alive. A spectacular finish to another spectacular career for Steph Curry, Steve Kerr, and both members of the Celtics and the Warriors showing their respect after a hard-fought six games. It's really one of the heartwarming scenes every year on this night. These incredibly talented athletes, wildly successful young men, acting with the joy and happiness of a child when they finally win it. All the hard work, all the sacrifice has paid off as they reach the goal. And knowing that they didn't do it alone, they did it together. This accomplishment, a bond that they'll have for the rest of their lives, and for a number of these Warriors, their fourth championship. They'll have to celebrate on the road again. Three of their four titles they've clinched on the road. And there's Andre Iguodala showing such respect to the young star, Jason Tatum, who had brilliance in these playoffs but fell short in the finals.
We did it, Cole. We did it, man. We did it, Cole.
Bruce Frazier, the head coach. Mark, you've known Steph Curry since he got into this league. When you see these emotions from this great player, what goes through your head?
You get emotional also, realizing how much he put into this ball game, how much he put into being an all-time great. Facing adversity, facing constant injuries, things not going the way he wanted them to go, continued to work his tail off, and has chased down some of the greats to ever play in the history of this game. It's inspiring to watch.
Jeff, you see their championship form again. It really is a sight to behold how well they play in the biggest moments.
Well, I thought defensively after a rough start, they were absolutely tremendous. And then Curry carrying a limited offensive team to a championship. He'll never have a greater impact on a team than this year, what he did in these playoffs. Truly, truly a remarkable performance in these finals.
And I think he'll finally get that NBA Finals MVP that so many talked about, something that was missing from his trophy case. Right now he's with Lisa.
Steph, we can see the emotion. Where is it all coming from? What's going through your mind right now?
Man, I'm so proud of our group. I thank God every day that I get to play this game at the highest level with some amazing people. I mean, we do know this is what it's all about, playing for a championship and what we've been through the last 3 years. The beginning of the season, nobody thought we'd be here, except everybody on this court right now. It's amazing. It's very surreal, though, very surreal.
You've been here before, three times, as a matter of fact, before this. Why do you think this moment means so much to you right now?
We were so far away from it. We were here for five straight years and got three of them. Then you hit rock bottom with injuries and the long road of work ahead and just trying to fill in the right pieces and the right guys. And nothing, you ever take this for granted, because you know, you never know when you're going to be back here. And to get back here and get it done means the world.
It looks like you shared a special moment with your dad. What was he saying to you?
He's just proud. I mean, he played 60 years in the league, and you know, we get to share all these experiences together, so he's just proud of me.
Congratulations to you, Seth. You're a champion again.
Thank you, thank you.
Come here, girl!
Yeah. like all the elite players, the greatness becomes routine. You grow accustomed to his electrifying performances. Another one tonight here to clinch his fourth NBA championship. Curry, Thompson, Green, Iguodala, and of course Steve Kerr all win their fourth NBA title with these Warriors. Kevon Looney is third, and then you have the veterans like Wiggins and Porter and Lee and Payton getting there first, as does the young players like Poole and Kuminga. What he was talking about with Lisa Jeff is what you said, that 1920 season after Klay Thompson suffered that devastating injury. Curry only played five games. They win 15. And then last year, Klay Thompson still out. They lost in the play-in. And as soon as Klay Thompson comes back and healthy, things turn around.
So many great stories on that floor. Overcoming a lot of adversity as a team, individually and collectively. They deserve to take a bow.
And Curry had that late season injury. You know, they suffered during that time and lost some chances to get home court advantage. And the way it worked out in the East, they still had home court advantage in the finals. And these last three wins, truly outstanding.
That's the seventh title in franchise history. And Steve Kerr now has nine NBA championships, five as a player, four as a head coach. And the Warriors clinch here in Boston. It's only the second time in the storied Celtic Finals history that a team has won a championship and clinched a championship here in Boston. The Lakers did it. And now Steph Curry and the Warriors. So there'll be no game seven as Boston came out strong, went up by as many as 12. It looked like the Celtics were ready to go and ready to force a game seven. But Golden State has seen it all during all these years. You knew it early. He wanted to wrap it tonight. Sure, it'd be nice to do it in front of the home crowd, but they wanted business to be taken care of right here tonight in game six. And Steph Curry made sure that happened as the emotions and the tears came pouring out late in this one. His father set such a great example for him. He's been around the NBA his entire life, first watching his dad play. Now his dad the one that gets to watch.
Here to present the Larry O'Brien Trophy to the Golden State Warriors, to team owners Joe Lacob and Peter Guber, and head coach Steve Kerr, is NBA Deputy Commissioner Mark Tidd.
Thank you so much, Lisa. What a phenomenal series and a great way to cap off the 75th NBA anniversary season. So the fans of Boston, the Bay Area, and fans around the world, thank you all for being a part of it. Congratulations to the Boston Celtics, the Eastern Conference champions, on a terrific season. And now the Golden State Warriors, six NBA finals in 8 years, four NBA championships, a remarkable run by any measure that only a handful of teams in the history of NBA have accomplished. To Joe Lacob, to Peter Guber, to Coach Kerr, to Bob Myers, to all you great players, the coaches, and the entire Golden State Warriors organization, congratulations. You are the 2022 NBA champions.
You can put it back.
Every year. Steph. Tell me.
Joe, when you purchased the team back in 2010, you said you wanted to reach the level of success of the Lakers and the Celtics. What does it mean to you to be handed that trophy again?
I mean, it means the world.
I just want to give all the credit to these players and these coaches. This is probably the most meaningful one because we came back. The last 2 years were very difficult, and what they've had to go through and the injuries, fantastic, and I love every one of them for what they've done.
Peter, let me ask you, as you watch this team throughout the season, what to you made it so special?
Makes it special. You never give up, never give in, go all the way. On the parquet floor, two Boston guys win it at the Garden.
Congratulations to you. Coach Kerr? Four championships, Steve, in the last eight seasons with the same core guys. What does that say about this group?
Well, number one, it says that the guy who put together this group did an amazing job, and I like Bob Myers to be recognized. He never gets enough credit. Bob, come on up. He's the guy who put the team together.
Bob, it's not easy. It's not easy to repeat success, to keep everyone happy, to keep the gang together. Just how have you been able to do that with this team?
Well, you know, you didn't ask this, but I want to thank all our wives and kids. It is not easy supporting us all year long, but it's the players. It's Steve, it's the players, it's Joe for supporting us. I'm thankful, Lisa, to just have been with these three guys basically my whole career. So it's a blessing every day.
Congratulations to you. And I have one more for you, Steve. This is now your ninth ring. Ninth ring, five as a player, four now as a coach. These journeys are always imperfectly perfect. Where do you rank this journey?
This might be the most unlikely one of all, but I've just been blessed. I hang around superstars. If you hang around superstars, good things happen. And that guy Curry, wherever he is, there he is right there. Go talk to him. He's the reason for all this.
All right, thank you, Steve. Congratulations. Now let's bring back Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum to present the 2022 Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player Award.
Thank you, Lisa. He's a four-time NBA champion, a two-time league MVP, a member of our 75th anniversary team, and for the first time ever, he's an NBA Finals MVP. The 2022 Bill Russell NBA Finals MVP Award goes to Stephen Curry.
It's been a lot of talk about this. What does it mean to you to finally get this Finals MVP?
It means we won. It means we took advantage of the opportunity to get back here. And I mean, I hear all the conversations. I hear all the chatter. We hear all the chatter. At the end of the day, it's about what we do on the floor. Ain't got to talk about it. Just got to go do it. And that's what this is about.
You said it during our post-game interview just three seasons ago. You guys had the worst record in the league. At what point did you believe that you could be back up here on this stage?
You always had a doubt, but you know how long the road is to get back here because of how hard it is to win on this level. Boston's a great team. Every team we played in the West is great teams. But we found a way to just get it done. And everybody on the stage had a part in this. From the front office, coaches, players. At the beginning of the year, what were they saying? We weren't even on the radar. And now we're here with two trophies, and it means a lot.
Every championship journey is different. How would you describe this one?
Just combining our championship pedigree and our experience with some fresh energy, some guys that are really hungry to take their next step. But we've built this for 10, 11 years. And that means a whole lot when you get to the stage because you know how to win. And everybody who's been a part of this knows what that's about. So this one hits different. This one hits different for sure.
Congratulations to you, Steph. Where's Clay? Come on up here, Clay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. How are you, boy? I love you, boy.
Clay, after everything that you have been through in the last 3 years, what does it feel like to be a champion again?
Oh, man. I mean, 2 years off, it wasn't really off. Watching the finals and the playoffs the last couple years would kill me. And just to be back on this stage, I'm so thankful for my teammates. The start they had this year, 18-2, it really laid the foundation for what was to come. And it's crazy. I'm on cloud 109 right now, Lisa. I don't even know what to say.
The times that you told us that it was hard to see this, when your foot was in a cast, when your leg was atrophied from surgery, how were you able to push through to focus on what could be getting back here?
Well, I had to have my big bro talk me off the ledge a few times. I couldn't drive. I couldn't do nothing. I was immobilized. And I'm such an athletic person. I love to be mobile. And he would just tell me, patience, patience. It's going to all pay off. Shout out to Seth as well, my little bro Trace. I mean, there's some dog days. There's a lot of tears shed on the bench. Steph talking me right, and even Draymond, and just leaning on those guys. Andre, I'm just thankful to be here, man. This is crazy, Lisa. I can't even believe it. I knew it was a possibility to see it in real time. Holy cannoli. This is crazy.
Holy cannoli. What do you think you'll remember most about this journey?
About the journey? Probably the dog days in Santa Cruz. It was me and Wise down there. We was playing a lot of pickup. I was getting busted up by our G League team, and I had to take it on the chest. I knew it would pay off. So to be here again, I'm so proud of every single person in this organization. This is crazy. And shout out to my Bahamian family in Nassau watching, my family in Vancouver, Washington. I love y'all. Can't wait to celebrate with you guys this summer.
Congratulations to you, Clay. Draymond, where are you? A special kind of love thing going on. Just what does it mean to get this title here in this building?
It means a lot. This fan base gave me a hard time, really hard time. And to come here and get a win is awesome. I appreciate this fan base. They brought incredible energy. Got to give kudos to them. But we did what we do. Welcome back to the Warriors Invitational, baby. It's what we do. Welcome back.
You had a lot of personal ups and downs in this series. What do you think you learned about yourself in this series?
I didn't learn anything about myself. I've been knew I was resilient. Maybe they thought otherwise, but nobody gave me this. I had to work every second of my life to get to this point. So I didn't learn much, but I'm a four-time champion with my brothers.
You guys all wanted this so much for Clay. How come?
I mean, you watch what he went through the last 2 years, and it's no surprise we sucked when he was out. And, you know, for him to battle back, come back January 9th, all the talk, he can't move, he's washed, he's this, he's that. My brother's a champion. That guy there, Clay, he don't lose. And we needed him back to do this. He's back, we back. It's a beautiful thing.
Congratulations to you, Draymond.
Thank you.
Thank you. Andrew Wiggins. This is something that you have dreamt about your entire life. How does the reality that you are now a champion, how does that compare?
Glory to God. You know, this is a dream come true. You know, I wouldn't be here without my teammates and, you know, everyone around me. So I'm just enjoying the moment. I'm loving it.
Why were you such a perfect fit for the Golden State Warriors?
I want to win. You know, that's what they do here at Golden State. They win. So they brought me along, and, you know, now we're winning together, and I'm just happy to be here.
When you first got traded, you told me that you were... When you first got traded, you told me that you were just so much looking forward to learning from Draymond and Steph and Clay about what it takes to be a champion. What do you think you learned?
It's hard. You know, this is every day. You know, every day is hard work, preparing yourself. What we're doing in November, you know, December, January, that prepares us for this moment in June. So I'm thankful for those guys.
Congratulations to you, Andrew. You are NBA champion.
Thank you.
Congratulations once again to all of the Golden State Warriors. the 2022 NBA champions and finals MVP, Steph Curry. Congratulations to you all.